and final week of the preseason is here. A fourth exhibition game is a thing of the past.
It's the Cleveland Browns and the Seattle Seahawks on EA Sports.
From the picturesque Pacific Northwest and the city of Seattle, welcome inside Lumen Field, where all the 12s make it at home for the Seahawks. Great to have you with us in this primetime battle. Mike Tirico and Greg Olson with you under the lights. We'll be putting in the spotlight the running backs. These are two teams, Greg, with bats who can tote it and carry it and make guys miss. But they're going to give us a fun old-school game on the ground here tonight.
Yeah, I think it's pretty cool, Mike, because, I mean, how many of these games have you and I done where we start out saying, all right, the quarterbacks, the wide receiver, these two electric passing games, that's how these offenses are built. But now we have a little bit of a throwback, and for two teams that unapologetically say, we are going to run our offense through the running back position, we don't see that so often anymore. So for two guys like us that understand and appreciate the legacy and the history of this game, I think it's kind of fun.
On the return, it's Laviska Shenault. And he is stopped at the 25. The drive will begin there. The Seahawks come on, and that means it's Geno Smith. What a story he's been. Real turnaround here in his 12th year now in the NFL. Came out to Seattle, backed up Russell Wilson the last 3 years. Greg, he has been the starter, and he runs this Seattle offense now.
You just can't say enough about Geno and his turnaround over the last couple years, Mike. I mean, many thought he was destined to just be a career backup and just play out the rest of his career. And when things didn't play out at first, instead of just listening to those doubters, he just kept working on his craft. And next thing you know, he gets an opportunity with a new team, makes the most of it, and he's now solidified himself as a bona fide franchise quarterback in this league.
They'll come up here on second down and 5. Once again, it's Walker. And the defense all over this one. They knock him down. It'll go down as a loss of 2.
The speed and the get-off by the big interior defensive tackle, Mike. I mean, he got through there so fast, he almost took the handoff himself.
Here's 3rd and 7. From the gun, it's Geno. He'll try to run for it.
Having a quarterback with this ability to run is such an X factor in today's NFL. It's an element of their offense that you have to be prepared for on every single play. Here we see it on 3rd down. Starts out as a pass. Nowhere to go with the ball. He tucks it, turns into a runner, picks up the 1st down.
Straight ahead, it's Walker. And that's the way you want to run it on 1st down. A gain of 7. Here's a 2nd and 3 forthcoming. We'll keep it on the ground and keep it with Walker. And they'll have it across midfield, down at the opposing 46-yard line. It'll be a pickup of 10. It's good for a Seahawks 1st down.
I think this 2nd down call, Mike, they were hoping that at worst, they had themselves set up for a 3rd down and short. But there's no need for 3rd down. He was able to get enough on 2nd, and they get a fresh set of downs.
And he finds some space, tackled after a gain of 7 on 1st down. Here's 2nd and 3 to go. On play action, Smith. With the tight end, that's Hank. And they're going to be set up in the red zone. They've got it inside the 15.
Offensively, landing a lot of body blows on this drive, Mike. Just the ability to steadily march the ball downfield and remain so efficient both run and pass. As they continue to wear this defense out, they have to find a way to end this drive with points. Anything short of that would be a bit of a letdown.
A fresh set of downs to work with. It is first down and 10. Working out of the gun, Smith. This one taken in by Chenault.
Nice job here by the defense. Did a good job just covering up everything for the most part. So once this ball was caught, really didn't have much of a choice but to just head out of bounds and pick up a modest gain.
From the pistol, Smith. He's got it at the three. And it'll be a short pickup. That's not enough for the first down.
Really nice timing on that slant route. You can tell the quarterback and the wide receiver are completely on the same page, and when executed at that level, it's virtually impossible to stop.
Now, this looks like a design run, and he will take it in himself. Geno Smith, touchdown Seahawks. A terrific way to start this one. Not only a touchdown, but a nice long march down the field. Makes it a long walk back to the bench for the defense.
Mike, that's about as good as you can imagine starting a game offensively. To be able to sustain that many plays and be able to cap it off with a touchdown, that is a dream start for this offense.
Jason Myers on to attempt the extra point. He gets it to go, and the Seahawks will take a 7-0 lead. Seven nothing is our score as this kick is sent into the air. To return is Naheem Hines. And he'll be brought down just beyond the 25-yard line. The Browns led out by their quarterback, Deshaun Watson. The stardom early in Houston. Now his third season with the Browns, eighth season in the league, as Watson tries to get this Browns team going in this one.
I don't know about you, Mike, but my biggest takeaway from our meeting with him was just how important it is that they get off to a fast start. He made it very clear. They wanted to put their opponent on their heels right from the jump. So I think early in this game, they're going to come out swinging right from their opening whistle.
Watson going to throw right away. He's got his man, the tight end, David Njoku. And he'll be taken down all the way up past the 45. That's a gain of 21 to open this drive.
These are the chunk plays they thought they could get here against this pass defense. They thought the passing game favored their offense in this matchup, and I think we can expect this to be the case the rest of the game.
Set to go now on first and 10. The Georgia Bulldog. Here's Nick Chubb. He'll manage to get two, maybe three on that carry. Rayshon Jenkins this time on the stop. Second and 7. Here's Watson. To the former Bronco, it's Jerry Jeudy. And they'll move this one down inside the 40-yard line. 11 yards on the pass there. It's a Browns first down. Moore going in motion. They'll get creative here on the jet sweep. That's 11 yards again, two plays in a row. And another first down. Watson, going to give it to Chubb. He's taken down just shy of the 10. That's a gain of 16. This offense is humming. A first down.
Let's give some love to the big guys up front here, Mike. The offensive line is looking good here early to start the game. A couple nice big explosive runs. Expect them to continue to lean on the big guys up front as the rest of this game unfolds.
So after one, 7-0 is our score. Greg and I back in the Great Northwest in a moment. Njoku, the tight end, is the one in motion. First and 10. It's Chubb. And he'll get this inside the 10, but not much further than that. Njoku, the tight end, is the one in motion. Once again, it's Chubb. He'll pop this ahead for about 4, but it will set up third down. Out of the gun, Watson. Zone, but it's incomplete. Amari Cooper was the man he was looking for, and it's going to lead to a fourth down.
They went for it all on that one, and just a little bit off. Ball winds up hitting the ground. They've got to move forward. The opportunities are out there. Better execution, better location, and they got some big plays in their future.
He is 2 for 2. That kick is good. And the Browns are on the board. It's 7-3.
It's always a little bit of a letdown, Mike. You find yourself deep in the red zone and you have to settle for a short field goal like that. In this case, he's able to put it through and they get 3.
The kickoff team is out on the field, and we're back to it as the kick's away. On the return, it's Chenault. Now an opening past the 30. A good return as he takes it across the 30. The Seahawks offense ready to possess the football for the second time. The lead sits at 4, so they'll try to add on to that. This drive begins with 1st and 10. This drive starts on the ground with Walker. And he's going to be bottled up quickly after a gain of about 1. Dalvin Tomlinson fighting off the blocks to make the play. Here's 2nd and 9. From the shotgun, it's Smith. They'll be forced to just throw that one away. It's incomplete.
Nice example there, Mike, of the quarterback just being smart with the ball, understanding it didn't quite develop the way he had intended. Throw that ball out of harm's way, live to play another down.
Third down and 9. From the shotgun, Smith. That's over the middle and intercepted. Picked off by Jordan Hicks.
So not a lot of yards on the return, Mike, but that's okay. The number one thing, end up with the ball in your hands. And in this case, mission accomplished, and his guys are headed off the field to celebrate.
The Browns offense ready to take over for their second possession. They'll start from the plus side of midfield, looking to possibly take the lead here. It's first and 10. On the handoff, this is Chubb. He'll work forward for a couple. The linebacker, Jerome Baker, there to make the play. Now, following the run, one of the offensive linemen leading the way is a bit shaken up. You hope against hope here in the preseason, especially, that it's not too serious. They'll come up on a second down and 8. Shotgun snap to Watson. That's into the hands of Judy on the right side.
I wouldn't be surprised if some point here in the future, Mike, this quarterback drops back. It looks like the same old hitch route underneath we've seen a few times, and they give a pump fake and go. You can lull a defense to sleep with a lot of these underneath quick game passes, and once you do, you can try to go for the big one.
Watson now on third down. He'll try and get there on the ground. Carrying that ball loosely, and it is out.
Mike, we hear that term run after catch so often, and sometimes people miss that there's kind of a middle phase. There's the catch, but before it turns into a run, you have to secure the ball as a ball carrier, right? It needs to be put away, properly held, points of pressure, front tip up against your body. All of that is kind of taken for granted. Catching it is just step one. You've got to secure the ball before you become a runner.
The Seahawks offense ready to take over once again. And remember now, all turnovers must be reviewed by replay. So this one is going to need a little closer look. At issue was the knee or any other body part except the hand down before the ball comes loose. And are the visuals convincing enough to overturn the call on the field? So that one overturned. They say the runner was down, and that will not be a fumble. First and 10. A run out of the gun. Here's Chubb. And he'll get 2 on this one before being taken down. Here's Chubb. And he's fighting to try to get back to the line of scrimmage, but will not do it. This is going to be a loss of a yard.
How often do we see linebackers be so fast trying to track down the ball carrier that they end up actually overrunning the play and allowing the running back to cut back? But not this guy. Does a great job staying in phase, stretching this ball out sideways, and he brings him down for a loss.
That's to the end zone, but they can't connect. It's incomplete.
I like the idea of taking your shot there on third down, pushing the ball downfield, looking for the touchdown. But now as it brings up fourth down, You're already this close. You're in field goal range. But do you keep that offense on the field and try to maintain possession and see if you can come away with six?
He is 2 for 2. That kick is good. And the Browns are back within one. It's 7-6.
And I can tell you firsthand, Mike, when you find yourself trailing in a game, you don't feel very good about coming away with field goals. But in this case, it does get them a little bit closer and cut into this deficit.
Both teams ready to go once more as the kick's away. On the return, it's Chenault. And he'll be brought down past the 25. Decent field position to start this drive. The Seahawks offense ready to get back to work. Their lead is just a point as they begin it on this drive with first and 10. Play action now. It's Geno. That's complete. It's Metcalf. And they will bring him down on the other side of midfield. An ideal beginning to this drive. 24 on the first play. 2 minutes to play in a tight one-point game in this first half. We're back to Seattle after this. On first down, here's Geno to throw. And he'll get this forward for positive yardage as he covers up in the end.
Well, give him some credit. Initially, that looked like it was going to be a sack. He's able to escape the pressure and get away, picks up a little bit of yardage, but at least he avoids taking that shot.
Now this is going to be a design run. They let him keep it.
They went to the design quarterback run, and there just wasn't a lot of space for the quarterback to operate. You can see him kind of waiting for some of the blocks to develop. Never transpired. Didn't get a whole lot going. Short game.
Third and 6. Smith to throw. That's caught. It's Kenneth Walker. And it looks like he's going to have the first down. What great work after the catch to extend the drive. Here's Geno. Terrific play all the way around, finished off by the receiver who not only made the grab, but Greg turned it up and takes it into the end zone.
And that's the tricky part, Mike, that transition from receiver to runner. And in this case, he does it flawlessly. Look the ball in, secure the catch, and then get upfield and get yourself in the end zone.
Myers now to add the PAT. He knocks it through. And the Seahawks will take a 14-6 lead. Still a little time. Final minute of this first half. We'll see if they can do anything with this kickoff that is coming their way. He'll work his way across the 25-yard line. The Browns offense can see what they can do in the final minute of this first half. The deficit is 8 as this drive begins with 1st and 10. The shotgun. Here's Watson. Off balance throw. It's complete. And he's going to get this one out to the 43-yard line. The Browns going to use the first of their timeouts here as the clock stops with 46 seconds remaining in the first half. Here's 1st and 10. It's Watson. He'll go right back to Njoku. He's got it again. And they'll get about 4 here as he is taken down. Here's a 2nd and 6. To throw is Watson. That's over the middle and caught by Judy. And he'll be taken down, but they are in business inside the 30-yard line.
And really the key to this play was just how fast he was able to get through his progressions. His mind was able to process and go from 1 to 2 to 3 so quickly that he was able to get the ball to the right target on time. And I think so often those two things are different. Being open is one thing. Being open and getting the ball on time, that's what leads to success, and that's what we saw here.
And he's brought down after a gain of 6 on 1st down. Dustin Hopkins on now for the field goal. This will be a 38-yard attempt. 3 for 3 in the game as this one is also good. And the Browns are back within 5.
And that's a really nice boost here before the break. I mean, you work the clock well. You're able to steal some points. The biggest thing is you're able to build a little momentum now going into the locker room at halftime.
Seven seconds, all that remains, till halftime. And the kick is away. This kick is fielded in the end zone, but no move to bring it out. It's touchback, and that ball will come out to the 30-yard line. Just going to run it here up the middle. And he'll plow forward for a gain of 4 yards. A 2nd down throw for Smith. And that is incomplete. One final chance does not work out. Time has expired. The first half has come to an end.
Okay, Mike, thanks very much. This, the final game on the preseason schedule for these two teams. After this comes final cutdowns. And then we get started for real. The countdown is on. for the NFL kickoff game on the Thursday after Labor Day. For the Seahawks in the first half, they were led by their quarterback, Geno Smith. He had a touchdown both in the air and on the ground to help push his guys into the lead at the break.
Coach, thank you. Both teams trying to find the right formula to come out on top in this second half coming up. Third quarter set to commence. And we're back underway here on EA Sports. Here's Hines now to return. And he'll be brought down right around the 25-yard line. The Browns offense looking to get back to work as we begin this third quarter. The deficit is 5, so they'll try to put a drive together here. They'll begin it with 1st and 10. The throw is Watson. And this ball's going to be incomplete.
It's rare to see an offense that finds themselves trailing and say, well, their quarterback's been actually one of their biggest bright spots. Usually that doesn't go hand in hand. So it's a little surprising to see him miss a throw like that on a day where he's completed passes at a highly efficient rate.
On the zone read, they hand it to Chubb. He'll get this ahead, gain of about 4, and it leads to 3rd down. Here's Watson. That's caught. It's the tight end, Njoku. 15-yard pickup there. 1st down, Cleveland.
I know, I'm biased. But listen, you can't convince me, Mike, that there's a better option on the field, especially when you got a guy like this that on 3rd down or critical moments, that's where the ball needs to go. The size, the speed, the matchup problems that he creates. If I was in a critical situation, there is no doubt where I'm going with the ball.
Running is Chubb. And they'll move this one down inside the 40-yard line. Give them 17 more, and they are on a roll. Another 1st down.
This just shows why you can't count on just one guy to take him down. He's a powerful enough runner. You've got to have guys coming in support when that first hit is made. It takes a team effort to stop him, especially once he gets going.
Watson will make the read and holds on. And he maneuvers his way forward, a gain of 6.
Good decision by the quarterback. In this situation, all you're looking to do is have a positive play. He decides to pull it, and that's exactly what he's able to do.
They'll work now on 2nd and 4. Watson to throw. He finds Judy on that one. And they bring him down inside the 25-yard line. A gain of 11 on that one. 1st down, Cleveland.
Points have certainly been hard to come by in this one today, Mike, but it seems like this drive has been what they've been searching for. A little bit of rhythm, the ability to sustain. Now they got to finish. Now they got to capitalize on these 1st downs and go finish with 6.
And he kept that play alive as long as he could. But the rush eventually gets to him and takes him down.
If your quarterback is going to make a habit, Mike, of operating outside the numbers or the outer third of the field, you better neutralize the EMO. So what EMO stands for is the end man on the line. It could be a defensive end, a linebacker, or any walked-up perimeter player who is responsible for setting the edge. You have to get them accounted for, because if not, you better keep your quarterback in the pocket, or else you're going to suffer a lot of sacks.
A lot of chances on that one. It was bouncing around, but it falls incomplete.
You can just see the reaction on the sideline. This defense thought they had themselves a critical stop. The mantra down here for all defensive coordinators, Mike, is takeaways, field goals. That's what you're trying to do, and man, they were this close to coming away with a huge takeaway.
And this ball incomplete on third down.
For the most part, he's been very accurate with the ball. I mean, he's completing over 60% of his passes, but because they haven't been able to get any big explosive plays, continue to push the ball downfield, hasn't really translated on the scoreboard just yet.
Another one through the uprights. He's 4 for 4 on the game. And the Browns will cut the deficit down to 2.
So it's not exactly what you're looking for when you set out on a drive, but at the same time, you don't want to come away empty-handed either. So in this case, they'll take those 3 points.
Kickoff team is out on the field, and we're back to it as the kick's away. Here comes D. Eskridge on the return, and he'll be brought down just beyond the 25-yard line. The Seahawks offense trotting back out for their first involvement of this second half. The lead is 2, and they're going to try to make something happen here, starting with a 1st and 10. It's Walker to start the drive. He'll work his way ahead for a gain of about 4. On 2nd down, Walker. And he's going to struggle to get back to the line, maybe a yard. That was Jordan Hicks who got him down. Third and 5. From the gun, it's Gino. And that is incomplete.
So on a day where he's completed give or take half of his passes, Mike, you have to imagine there's a handful of throws he'd like to have back, and I think that last one falls in that category. But the biggest thing, and most fortunately for them, they find themselves with a lead despite a bit of an up and down performance out of their quarterback.
He took a pretty good lick at the end of that one. Nick Chubb and the rest of the Browns offense set to take over again. They trail by 2 and will start this drive with 1st and 10. Watson. Oh, after the catch, he's hit, and the ball is out. And the defense has it.
You know, Mike, with the importance being placed on yards after the catch, we're seeing more and more guys really emphasize turning into a runner as soon as possible. And, of course, it's a critical part of today's modern offense. But the part you have to remember, the yards are never more important than protecting the ball, so it needs to continue to be stressed. Yes, we want the big explosive play after the catch, but never at the expense of the ball.
Out comes the Seattle offense as they get ready for their next possession. They've got the lead, and they'll set forth trying to build on it. They're going to do that with excellent field position. From the 35, it's 1st and 10. Working out of the gun, Smith. He'll complete it to Barner. And they'll get about half of what they needed. It's a pickup of 5 and sets up 2nd and 5.
This pitch and catch may have looked routine, but I promise you, Mike, these types of anticipatory throws, especially outside the numbers, they don't occur without countless reps, oftentimes when nobody's even watching.
They'll run here with Walker. With good blocking leading the way, he's got the first down inside the 25.
Second down at these distances, Mike, you pretty much anticipate a pass, and I think that's what the defense was lined up thinking. In this case, they leave a little too much room on the ground, and the offense is able to pick up a first down.
The tight end, Fant, in motion. They'll go play action. It's Smith. That is going to be hauled in. He's got it. Tyler Lockett. Touchdown, Seahawks. Now the point after drop from Myers. He's got it. And the Seahawks will make it a two-score game as they are now up 9. After the TD, Myers comes on now to kick it away. Here's Hines now to return. And he'll be brought down past the 25. Decent field position to start this drive. The Browns offense and quarterback Deshaun Watson getting set for their next drive. And it has been a rough night at the office. We go through the highlights. They are really lowlights. Relentless pressure. Receivers unable to get open. They cannot connect in the passing game. It has been a night to forget for the quarterback. The break the huddle coming up now for first and 10. Here's Watson. To the outside, a catch made by Moore.
Certainly not the biggest play of the day, but a good example of picking up positive yardage, staying ahead of the chains by a well-timed ball and a well-timed route.
They come to the line now on second and 2. They'll run right here with Chubb. He's got room to the 45. And he's down on the other side of midfield. Markham at the 48-yard line. They gain 18 yards on that one. It's a Browns first down.
Second and short. Normally, this is a great time, Mike, to put the ball in the air and try to press the ball downfield. But in this case, they keep it on the ground. Has a similar effect. They pick up a good gain and a first down.
So, three quarters have come and gone. EA Sports back for more from the NFL preseason after this. On first and 10, here's Watson. Now sets up a screen for Chubb. And they'll get about 4 here as he is taken down.
Just a little slow developing on that screen play there. It was pretty obvious to the entire defense exactly what was going on. Nobody was thinking pass. Nobody was getting back into their drops. And just nowhere for that back to go.
On second down, here's Watson. This throw left is complete with Judy. A gain there of 11. First down, Cleveland.
Not a whole lot complicated about this play, Mike. That was understanding where the holes of the defense were. Remember, in this zone coverage, you got to find green grass, get past the first down marker, be friendly to the quarterback, and then the ball has to be out on time before those zone defenders can react to the receiver. That's exactly how it played out here. You can draw up all the fancy plays you want, but when the quarterback and the receiver see it through the same set of eyes, it's virtually impossible to stop.
That's 11 yards again, two plays in a row, and another first down. A play fake. Now Watson to throw. Here's a shot toward the end zone. And that's going to wind up uncatchable out of the back of the end zone. It's incomplete. Jerry Jeudy, the intended target, and it'll bring up second down. There's a short throw caught by Njoku. And nice work after the catch. He stopped a little short of the first down marker, but it is a pickup of 9.
The timing of these RPO concepts, that's the entire key. Remember, Mike, different than the college game, these offensive linemen, they're blocking for the run. But if that ball gets pulled, the pass option of the play, they're not allowed downfield. In the college game, they get a 3-yard window that they're allowed to be downfield even on a forward pass. That's not the rule in the NFL. These decisions have to be made quickly. If not, even after a good pickup, you could be coming back due to a flag. A chance here for this back to really show his speed. He saw the room on the perimeter and he was able to get around the edge. Thought he was gonna get right to the pylon. Comes up just short, down near the goal line, sets up first and goal.
From the 1-yard line, first down and goal. Here's Chubb, and he will score. Game on. Nick Chubb, touchdown Cleveland. Greg, they are pecking away at this one now. Very big touchdown. Gets them right within reach of pulling this comeback off.
Well, Mike, at the very least, they've given themselves a chance, but can they get a stop and get the ball back again for a chance to go down and really make this one interesting?
Dustin Hopkins now to add the extra point. The kick is good. Important extra point. The difference is just 3, a field goal here in the fourth quarter. So the lead is down to just 2 now in the fourth quarter as they kick it off. Here's Eskridge now to return it. He'll work his way across the 25-yard line. The home team's offense ready to see what they can do. They'll begin with 1st and 10. On the bootleg, it's Smith. This one finds Lockett down the left side. And good yardage there after the catch. They'll wind up with a gain of 7 on first down. On play action, Smith. Lockett downfield, he's got it. And they will bring him down on the other side of midfield. Remember, he had the touchdown catch the last time they had the football. Here, he's got a first down.
Anybody who thought this coach was going to get conservative with this late lead is sadly mistaken, Mike. They're out here still throwing haymakers with this passing game. They're not content with just having the lead. They're looking to increase it.
So they come to the line for first down and 10. From the gun, here's the give to Walker. Oh, he pops up the football. And this is taken in by the defense.
And as you can see with that fumble, Mike, it really just goes back to the fundamentals of how they're taught to carry the ball. And they talk about the points of pressure. And the biggest thing really, Mike, is you want the front tip of the ball, the part where your fingers cover, to always be higher than the back tip of the ball. So often you see that front tip go down, and it makes it so much easier for that defender to kind of rake it out. So you want pressure against the outside of the ball, both tips, the inside of the ball, and then keep that front point up.
On first down, it's Watson. Toward the middle, that's caught by Moore. And he's going to be brought down up past the 45. They'll gain 17 on that one. A very quick first down.
This is clinic tape for any young wide receiver out there watching this guy run routes. He has the defender thinking everything is a go ball. Attack him vertically, and then when you get to your route depth, you stick that foot in the ground, you break in, balls on time, results in a nice first down pickup.
So 2 minutes left to play in the second half. We'll come back and finish this one off after this. Second and 6 coming up. They'll drop to throw. This is brought in downfield by Judy. They get an even 20 on that one. It's a Browns first down.
We spent so much time talking about these receivers. How fast do they run, Mike? How high do they jump? But so often, the guys that have the most success in the NFL, it's the mental part of the game. It allows them to create separation, find soft spots in the defense, attack defenders. It's exactly what he's able to do here, and really nice connection.
Here comes second down. Jump. And he will not be able to get free, picking up only a yard. Now it's third down. The shotgun. Here's Watson. That is incomplete. Here we go. They're down to what could be their final play. It's fourth down.
They desperately needed that one, Mike. Down here late, they've only got a few remaining snaps to go, and it puts all of the pressure of the game now on fourth down. Let's see what play call they have in a gotta-have-it situation, and right now, this quarterback needs to make his best throw in the biggest moment of the game. And this has been such a tight game, but that's a big one right there. I mean, you need a kicker with confidence. Well, this guy, he fits the bill. He steps up and knocks it through to give his guys a lead here in the fourth quarter.
So, after the field goal to take the lead, kicker is back out there to send this one away. Here's Eskridge now to return it. And he'll be brought down just beyond the 25-yard line. the offense, and is back out, captained, of course, by their quarterback. And we run you through the highlights here. It has been a very big performance from the quarterback position, instrumental in leading and executing, and now trying to finish strong and take his team to the finish line. This is first and 10. From the shotgun, it's Smith. He'll get this complete to Walker.
Great example of first down efficiency. You don't always have to go for the big play, but put yourself in a friendly second down. Now you have equal opportunity to both run and pass.
Now, second and inches. From the shotgun, Smith. He's going to tuck it and go. Final minute, still two timeouts remaining as we get to first and 10. Throwing it right into the hands of his running back.
All right, so there's really three areas that a modern NFL running back has to excel at. Number one, the traditional handoffs. Yes, you have to operate out of the backfield like a traditional running back. Number two, you have to be excellent and reliable in pass protection. And maybe bigger than all of them, you have to be at least serviceable out of the backfield in the passing game.
On second down, Smith. And that one knocked away. It's incomplete. Jackson Smith and Jigba, the intended receiver. And now it's going to be third down.
The game is there for the taking. They control their own destiny, but this brings up a really big third down here. But remember, they don't have to force it and push the ball past the sticks. Even if they come up short, they still have fourth down in their back pocket to try to extend this drive and see if they can pull out the win here late.
He was looking for Kenneth Walker out of the backfield. And it's going to bring up fourth down.
Great job there defensively separating the man from the ball. And this is the moments of the game where you need your best players to step up. And this guy's showing what he's capable of doing in the game's critical moment.
That's taken in. The wrist pays off to the tune of 16 yards.
Every once in a while, it just comes down to you need somebody in the huddle to just make a play, and it wasn't a whole lot fancy here. The quarterback just dumps the ball down, a quick underneath completion, and then really it's the yards after catch that did the rest, and that's what it takes. You're not always going to have the perfect play. You're not always going to dial up the perfect play against the perfect look. Sometimes players need to make plays, and that was a good one there.
Connected with the tight end. That's Fant. And this takes him into the red zone. He's brought down inside the 20-yard line. This offense still has the one timeout to use. First and 10 coming up now. Back is Smith. Now he'll run. The Seahawks have got a first and goal. He's out of bounds at the 4-yard line. Gain of 12 and a first down.
When you find yourself trailing here late in the game, decision making is critical. Not only is he able to extend the drive by picking up the first down with his legs, great job by the quarterback understanding, get out of bounds, stop the clock. Save as much time as possible as they try to make a comeback.
And he's going to be stopped just short of the goal line. Couldn't reach that ball across, setting up second and goal. the pressure's on. And here's the veteran, Jason Myers. This to take the lead at the end of regulation. So, a big one coming for their veteran kicker. This one, he's gotta have. This kick is good! And they take the lead here late in this preseason battle.
Well, there's no more pressure-filled spot for a kicker than that one right here, Mike. I mean, it's very simple. You make it, you win. You miss it, you lose. And what's he do? He comes through to not only give his team the lead, but most likely the victory.
Down to the final few seconds of this one as the kick is away. Here's Hines now to return. He'll get this past the 20 before he's brought down shy of the 25-yard line. They'll come up for first and 10. Back to throw is Watson. Gonna look deep, looking for more. And that's gonna be incomplete. The defense holds here in the final minute, and they're gonna get out of here with a victory. So the 12th man, a factor here, as it's a win for the Seahawks. They finish the preseason on an up note. Have a couple weeks to get ready for the season opener coming in September. So that'll just about do it for Greg Olson and our entire team. I'm Mike Tirico. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, log on to easports.com. It's a win for the Seahawks. As we say, so long from Seattle.